So lastly, what I want to talk to you about is you finished out your day. You don't have a bird slung over your shoulder, so you got to find a bird for the next day. And generally, what you want to do is roost a bird. You want to put them to bed. Save the last half hour of the day so you can go out, find a gobbler, find out which tree he's spending the night in. That way, the next morning, you know which tree to set up in, so you're right on top of him, and he doesn't have to know you're there. You don't have to make a peep. Get in, you set up, you know he's in that tree 75 yards from you. You might actually be able to even see him when the sun starts coming up. But it increases your odds tenfold if you can get in on the tree he's spending the night in, and you don't have to make a peep, because anytime you're out making owl hoots or whatever to locate a bird, it obviously wakes them up. It puts them a little bit on alert, and you know, you gotta walk into that woods and try and be as quiet as you can. But if that bird's up and he's looking around, there's a good chance that he can pick you off too, you know, as you're trying to come in on him. So if you can get in on him without making a peep, get in as tight as you can and go that extra tree, and you don't bust him, your odds are gonna improve, like I said, tenfold for the kill for the next day. But you say to me, okay, well, how do I locate that gobbler when he goes back to roost? Well, a lot of times birds will gobble either just before or after they fly up to roost at night, just like they do in the morning, not as intensely. They might gobble once or twice and that might be it. But especially if they're without hens, they'll gobble because they want those hens to come in around his roost and roost also. So the next morning he's got a nice little harem where he can fly down and pick and choose who he wants to go with. But even birds with hens will gobble a lot of times too to try and draw in more hens to them. But get up on a high ridge, listen for gobbles. You know, if you don't hear anything, start using the owl hoot again. Crow call doesn't always work late in the day, but an owl hoot will, because the owls are starting to wake up and call again, because owls are obviously a nocturnal bird. They start waking up just before dark and they start calling. And just see if he sounds off. He sounds off here, he sounds off there, wherever. Get one to sound off. If you can't do that with your mouth, by the way, Holland Custom Calls makes an owl hooter that works pretty nice. It's not as loud as using your voice, but it's got a pretty good tone to it. But however you want to do it, get that gobbler to sound off. Don't get him going gobble, 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 because that's, for one thing, it's going to attract more hens to him. It might attract more hunters to him if you're hunting public ground or you're hunting on private land with some other hunters. But get him to go once or twice just so you know the general area he's in. Then get close to him and make him go one more time so you can pick out the tree that he's in. Once you can do that, you're going to up your odds, way up your odds from just going out cold in the morning and trying to locate a bird. But I'd like to show you a little bit more, but the woods right now just aren't real conducive for me to get out and show you how to set up and everything else. But I think you get a pretty good idea. And like I said, pay attention to cadence when you're calling. If you're a first-time caller, a new caller, tone isn't as important as cadence. Tone is important. I mean, if you're going to make a bunch of squeaks and whatever else, it's not going to be good. But this is a new call, it's not broke in yet. Doesn't sound real nice, but you can hear the cadence. The muck, 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 muck. If you're going muck, 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 doesn't sound like a hen. Got no rhythm, you got no cadence. Real hens have a cadence to their calling. They might start out slow and build up and go faster. They might call fast all the time. Young birds a lot of times will. They'll kee-kee and then they'll yelp. But then old mama's gonna say, ha ha ha! cadence, rhythm. Put some cadence, put some rhythm, put some emotion in your calling, and you'll do just fine this spring. Well, I hope I could teach you a little something today about turkey calling, and look for a DVD hopefully sometime out next spring. I want to put something together that is going to actually show you calling in real life situations in the field, calling birds in, and what to do, what not to do. Some things I've learned through trial and error over the years that I'd like to teach to you so you don't have to go through the school of hard knocks. But check me out on the internet, check my website out. I've got videos for sale on there, and as soon as I get a good spring turkey video put together, I'll have that up too, www.pronghornproduction.com. I might have something going with Team Hammerdog. Check them out on the web at www.teamhammerdog.com. And one way or the other, we're going to get something out to you guys that's going to be educational and entertaining at the same time. Till next time. Turkey Calling 101 Version 2 has been brought to you by Pronghorn Productions, in association with America's Outdoorsman, Team Hammerdog Outdoors, and Holland Custom Call. Check us out on the web at www.pronghornproduction.com.